Can you imagine Jesus as a kid just like you? We often hear the stories of baby Jesus or when Jesus, you know, is an adult with his 12 disciples, but we forget that Jesus had a childhood and probably did many of the same things that other children do growing up. Although Jesus did many ordinary things like helping his parents and playing with other kids, Jesus was different. He is the God the Son and he's perfect in every way. You know, sometimes our parents tell us, oh, my precious child, you're so perfect. But Jesus really was perfect. And he had come to earth for a purpose, to bring people back to God. When Jesus was 12 years old, he went with Mary and Joseph to Jerusalem to celebrate the Passover. Many people travel from all over for this week-long celebration. The Passover was a celebration of God saving his people from slavery and death in Egypt. Remember Moses? Well, as part of the celebration, Mary, Joseph, and Jesus went to the temple to worship and offer sacrifices. While Jesus was in the temple, he noticed some of the finest instructors of the law were teaching. And when we say the law, we mean like the Bible, the scripture, the word. Jesus listened and began asking them questions. He was very interested in what they were talking about in the temple, and the teachers were also amazed at what Jesus already knew. Remember, he was only 12 years old. After the celebration, it was time to go back home, and Joseph and Mary started back on their trip back home to Nazareth. They thought Jesus was in the group with amongst his friends, but it wasn't until nighttime they realized that Jesus was not with them. They were so worried, like, where could it be? Mary and Joseph began asking people, have you seen Jesus? Have you seen my son? But Jesus was nowhere to be seen. So they hurried back to Jerusalem. They searched the whole city, the marketplace where they had stayed, and even the temple. Imagine their surprise when they saw what Jesus was doing inside the temple. Jesus was listening and discussing the law, the scripture, with the important high priests and teachers. This was highly unusual. Imagine, like, you know, you're 12 years old and you're at the Congress or the White House, like, discussing all the policies and government laws with the senators and congressmen, right? That's unusual for a 12-year-old. How could a 12-year-old boy understand all the law and the meaning? But not only was Jesus asking questions, the teachers were asking Jesus questions too. It was really, truly amazing. Everyone was astonished at Jesus's understanding and his answers. Jesus knew the scripture and could answer questions because he is the Son of God who knows everything. Remember, Jesus was always in heaven before with God when God created the universe, created us. So Jesus knows everything. Imagine how relieved Mary and Joseph felt once they found Jesus. He had actually been missing and away from his parents for 3 whole days. Mary began to scold Jesus because, you know, moms get scared when they, you know, lose their children. So she says, son, why have you done this to us? We were so worried about you. But you know what Jesus said? Why were you searching for me? Didn't you know that I would be in my father's house? You see, Jesus was obeying what God, his father, wanted him to do. At this time, Mary and Joseph couldn't fully understand what Jesus meant by this. Even though they knew he was God's son and believed that, you know, he was a promised savior, they didn't understand what business Jesus had to do in the temple. Although Jesus was only, again, 12 years old, he already knew of his special relationship and connection to his father, God. He was excited about doing what his father, God, had planned for him. But Jesus also knew it was important to obey God by obeying his earthly parents. Jesus went back home with Mary and Joseph so that they can raise him and take care of him. Sometimes, you know, God might want us to obey him, which can be different than what our parents might tell us to do. So, you know, when this happens and when you're confused and unsure about, you know, what to do, make sure you trust God and pray first. God will give you the wisdom to do the right thing so that you can obey God and honor your parents. In the years that followed, Jesus grew strong in his mind and his body, as well as in his walk with God. Jesus continued to work with Joseph as a carpenter. He grew just like other boys his age, and not only did he obey Joseph and Mary, but he always obeyed his father, God.